guys, part 2 of making zinc sulfide. In this video, we are going to make zinc sulfide glowing dark powder. In the previous video, we made two powders, zinc and copper powder. Copper powder can be made by just reacting copper sulfate with aluminium. But I said about making iron nails. So let's start. Dissolve. Mix 15.35 grams of zinc in crucible, and mix 17.49 grams of sulfur powder. This has to be extra pure. Some use the flower one, the garden. We have to break all the clumps made with. Mix it thoroughly. All clumps must be destroyed once. We have to use stoichiometric amount. The copper can be used as impurity to make it glowing dark. We are going to use UV light. Now add copper metal, 1.44 grams. This displaces some of the sulfur atoms, which is zinc cannot. Mix it thoroughly. Sorry for the inconvenience being for the voices being produced in the background. It takes some time to get it thoroughly mixed. Make sure that all has been mixed thoroughly. Now, for the reaction, keep it on upon the furnace. It is 1700 degrees Celsius. This can be used. This is a homemade furnace. It takes some time to react. Be careful, the gas is being produced. Let it be react. The sulfur will burn into sulfur dioxide and trioxide gases, so be careful. And the dust must be, dust is always harmful for us. You must watch the reaction. Sorry for the inconveniences. It takes some time to react. It needs high temperature. Don't use any glassware because it can be breaked with high heating. Always must use ceramics and others because it can withstand huge temperatures like 1200 degrees Celsius and 1300 degrees Celsius. So it is very appropriate. See, it's melting and it's now reacting. The zinc has been melting and is reacting. Oh, it's been formed into clumps. I never tried this reaction. Now it has been reached to 400 degrees Celsius, which is the melting point of zinc. So it's reacting. And the sulfur has melting point of 115 degrees Celsius, 115 and 114. It means it has been reacting. Be careful about that gas being produced. I am doing this outside. You can also do in a fume hood. Some also use oxypropane torch. for just in 1 second reaction. But I don't have oxypropane torch. I had the danger about the oxypropane torch, so I used furnace. It's quite being safe. Now it has been reached to till 500 degrees Celsius. My steel rod has been. Heat until load reacts. To raise the heat, we have to. Sulfur dioxide has a property of killing someone. It is usually found in crackers. I never tried this reaction. I am doing this very first time. So keep the glass rod between it. The reaction is zinc plus sulfur plus copper. Some of the atoms are displaced by the copper, so this is zinc sulfide. It takes some time, but it works. If you want to use oxypropane, you can use that one. Always use this one. Now time to take off. Do you need adult supervision to do this? Okay, so the four after this reaction, we have to close this now. What for inconveniences about keeping my hand in against it? Sorry for the voices. Voices. Let me put it. We put the UV rays which can activate its my camera cannot catch it, but it's glowing. So much is glowing. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe and rate and comment.